The independence of America, considered merely as a separation from England, would have been a matter of but little importance had it not been accompanied by a revolution in the principles and practice of governments. She made a stand, not for herself only, but for the world, and looked beyond the advantages herself could receive. The Founding Fathers, however, believed that power alone is not justification, only explanation. Simply put, governments that rule by violence or the threat of violence are illegitimate and unjust. In 1776, America turned the world topsy-turvy when it declared independence. We declared independence not based on power and force, but on a foundation of a set of founding first principles. As the Declaration of Independence states, we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, and that to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed. That when any form of government becomes destructive of these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or abolish it and to establish new government, laying its foundation on such principles and organizing its power in such form as to them shall seem most likely to affect their safety and happiness. Those words from the Declaration of Independence were revolutionary in 1776, and they remain revolutionary today. Thus, America became the pivot point in modern world history. We relegated to the past the old dark ways of power and vice and embraced the first principles of the rule of law, unalienable rights, equality, the social compact, limited government, and revolution. To understand America and our Constitution, we need a better grasp of our founding first principles. These are the first principles that were articulated in our Declaration of Independence. Yet, during the time following the Declaration of Independence and before the adoption of the Constitution, the founders drifted from those first principles. This period is known as the Crisis. States began to threaten the inalienable rights of their own citizens by invalidating contracts and threatening other property rights. Trade wars raged between the states, and the states conducted their own foreign policies. Insurrections also arose in the states. Although they had won the war, the states were not able to secure the peace. 55 delegates from across the states met in a long and hot summer in Philadelphia in 1787. George Washington, the commander of the Continental Army, which had won the improbable war of revolution against the British, presided over the convention. Delegates included James Madison, Alexander Hamilton, Benjamin Franklin, and many other notables across the states. The document they produced became the living embodiment of the first principles. In fact, the Constitution included a host of groundbreaking elements in modern history. A supreme law of the land adopted by the people in a written constitution. A government of limited, enumerated powers specified in the written constitution. A separation of powers between the three branches of government, that being the legislative and Congress, the executive and the president, and the judicial in the Supreme Court and lower courts. Checks and balances between the various branches of government. Federalism, in other words, a division of authority between the states and the federal government. A bicameral Congress in which a Senate and a House would both act to protect the liberty of the people. A president indirectly elected by the people. A House of Representatives directly elected by the people. A Senate representing the interest of each state. Frequent and set elections. The elimination of hereditary offices and nobility. Specific written protections of personal liberty, including prohibitions against ex post facto laws and bills of attainder. a provision for incorporating new territories as political equals, not colonies, into the Union. The elimination of religious tests to hold political office. The subordination of the military to civilian authority. The division of war powers between the executive and legislative. Requiring appropriation bills originating only in the House of Representatives. And a process of legalized bloodless revolution through future constitutional amendments or conventions. Even with all these innovations to protect liberty, some were dissatisfied with the draft of the Constitution produced by the Constitutional Convention because of the glaring omission of a Bill of Rights. Many prominent political leaders such as Patrick Henry and George Mason attacked the omission of a Bill of Rights as a serious affront to liberty. Although the Convention's draft was eventually ratified by the states and became the law of the land, it was done so with the understanding that a Bill of Rights would soon be added. And pursuant to that understanding, James Madison quickly drafted and a Bill of Rights was quickly enacted by Congress and the states. The Bill of Rights provides Americans with express guarantees of their unalienable rights, including the free exercise of religion, the prohibition of the state establishment of religion, the freedoms of speech and free press, the right to assemble, the right to petition the government for redress of grievances, the right to bear arms, the prohibition of quartering troops, the prohibition of unreasonable searches and seizures, the rights to due process, trial by jury, the right to counsel, the right to a speedy trial, the right to a grand jury, and the right to confront one's witnesses. The prohibitions against self-incrimination and double jeopardy. The prohibition of taking private property by the government for any reason other than for a public purpose and only with just compensation. The prohibition of cruel and unusual punishments and excessive bail. The reservation of all rights not enumerated in the Constitution to the people or the states. And the reservation of unenumerated powers to the state governments. America's embodiment of the first principles created an unparalleled constitutional structure, majestic and thorough, yet plain and simple. Much like a clock, the failure of one piece can shut down the entire mechanism. There is no doubt that the Constitution was an imperfect instrument. For example, it allowed slavery and didn't provide any rights for women. Yet it was by far the most revolutionary and freedom-embracing government the world had ever seen, and it's become a torch of liberty, a beacon of hope for billions of people across the world. The first principles articulated in the Declaration of Independence and embedded in the Constitution led this country over a long and difficult road to change for the better. Millions have sacrificed to make those principles become alive. Inspired by those first principles of equality, unalienable rights, and the social compact, the slaves were emancipated, women and racial minorities enfranchised, and all gained fundamental rights. Although the struggle is not complete, there can be no doubt that our Constitution continues to inspire our people and peoples across the globe to seek and win their liberties and freedoms. Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, Earl Warren, remarked that liberty is not necessarily our permanent possession. Both external and internal pressures constantly assail it. It is axiomatic that every generation, to keep its freedom, must earn it through understanding the past, vigilance in the present, and determination for the future. The question before you now is whether you are up to that challenge.